Is Bitcoin about to get dumped soon by 1.1 million Bitcoin? What does this article have to do with that question? And is that article legit after all? We will answer all those questions. We will apply a secret Scambuster tool, give it on your hands as well, so you can use them to discover scams also in the ICO and, more important, initial exchange offering space. So it will be entertaining, it will be horrifying. Make sure you stick here for the whole episode. It won't be even a long one. So that being said, welcome crypto friends and welcome back to MM Crypto. My name is Chris, and as always, we want to get straight into the content. If you are excited already, make sure you smash up the like button, it's for free. And we want to tell you, this article right here, it was recently leaked, is about the Tulip Trust. A lot of you guys might have already heard about it. All of you guys have already heard about Mr. Dr. Craig Wright. Obviously, guys, most of us will have the same opinion about him, but we have to take things seriously. We have to stay objectively. And whenever you see something like a potential danger of 1.1 million Bitcoin about to get dumped right here on the 1st of January 2020, as you know, he is a Bitcoin enemy. Whenever those news occur, we want to check out whether they are legit or not. And also, you will find out there's already some people speculating about that article. Some people say it's true. Some other people say you can trace back some of his alt Bitcoin back to Mt. Gox wallet and so on. But this amount of Bitcoin right here is exactly the amount being mined by the Satoshi Nakamoto group or person. So what we will do right now is we will apply that Scambuster tool, and we can tell you guys, do not be afraid or scared all too much right now. Just sit down and watch that episode. So what we will do is we will apply that Scambuster tool and show you whether he is Satoshi Nakamoto or not, and also whether this danger here is real or not. Before we want to start with that exciting content, we want to thank our sponsor for joining us today to make that episode possible, to supporting that channel. It will be a 10 second pre-roll campaign. Check it out. The link is also in the description down below. So thank you so much for sponsoring us. Yes, sir. So thank you so much for sponsoring us, guys. And now let's get straight into the content. First of all, a lot of people might come now and say, wow, why are you talking about Dr. Craig Wright? Everyone knows that he's a con artist. Everyone knows that he's a scam. But guys, just let's go to coinmarketcap.com before we discover whether this article is true or not. Let's go here, and you will find that Bitcoin SV is still on rank number 12. Valued with more than $1 billion. So there are actually still so many people out there not knowing that this guy is a scam, that this guy is a con artist. And I mean, we really want to show you and give you evidence for that. Also, guys, if you think that Craig Wright is not Satoshi Nakamoto, make sure you smash up the like button and also leave your thoughts about him in the comment section down below. And don't be too cruel. Obviously, always remember, this guy is also a human being, obviously with some strange thoughts, but don't be too cruel. But we want to know your opinion about him. So first of all, to discover whether he might be Satoshi Nakamoto, we wanted to go back in time, go back into his blog, especially in this blog pre-Bitcoin, so in 2008 and stuff. And we wanted to go there, but what we found out is that this blog was removed in 2008, on the 24th of August, we wanted to go into the archive. So this was removed by whom? Obviously, most probably, it was removed by Craig Wright himself. So what we did is we copy pasted that link into a Wayback Machine. If you go to web.archive.org, you can just copy past all links, also from websites like Certik.com, for example, Certik.org, the new initial exchange offering of Binance, and you can copy past that link into this search engine right here. And we will use it, this whole Craig Wright story right now, to show you how that works, and we will help you also on your due diligence on ICOs and, more important, initial exchange offerings, because a lot of those initial exchange offerings are coming out right now, but they are ICOs, recently ICOs from 2018, 2017, which failed to time the market and now are trying themselves with an IEO. And it's very useful to use that Wayback Machine, because what it does actually is when you are copy pasting that link in here and you are selecting the date, it's giving you a snapshot from the history. So even though you remove something from the web, it's still there in the web archive in the Wayback Machine. So what we did is we took his old blog and we copy pasted it in here, and you can see this is the snapshot from the 2nd of June 2014. And if you scroll down a little bit, okay, you can see that Craig Wright posted on this 26th of August, 4 days before the Bitcoin white paper was released. I think like 4 days. Don't quote us on that. Maybe it was 1 month, but we think on the 30th of August, the Bitcoin white paper was released, somewhere around that, okay? He said in that article, and this is the line we have to take an eye on: tomorrow, back to the DNS paper, my statistics dissertation and work. So far, so good. But if we go 1 year later, so let's go to the 25th of May 2015, and a Reddit article was pointing out that as well. If we go to that same thing right here, tomorrow back to the DNS paper, yada yada, you will find that sentence right here: I have a cryptocurrency paper out soon. We don't even know if the word cryptocurrency was used back then, but that's not the point. 20 years, triple entry bookkeeping, BDO was good for something. Dude, this is crazy. This guy actually went there, and it has to be Craig Wright because it was posted by him as well. He went there and he edited his own post to write in that he had a cryptocurrency paper out soon. And this tech guy with a doctor title and I don't know, like PhDs and everything, he is not thinking about that we are able to use that Wayback Machine. Dude, this guy is maybe intelligent and he has some degrees, but he is not really, really clever after all. So what we are able to do with that Wayback Machine is we can discover that he is lying about that article and putting in that he was working on that Bitcoin white paper 4 days before it was released. So this is the definite proof that he is a liar. Would Satoshi Nakamoto really go that way and edit some posts to prove that he is Satoshi Nakamoto? Or would he just use the noisy way, moving some Satoshis from that huge stack of Bitcoin, or maybe, I don't know, signing some transactions? That would be way easier, guys. So this guy is definitely not Satoshi Nakamoto, and if he is not Satoshi Nakamoto, then this article must be a fraud and must be a lie, because this exact amount right here is the exact amount mined by Satoshi Nakamoto or by that group. So we can already tell you for 100% certainty, in our opinion, obviously no financial advice, that Craig Wright is not Satoshi Nakamoto, and that we will never ever touch Bitcoin SV, even if it's falling down like 99% in price. We will never touch something which is built by a con artist. And what, in our opinion, and what you can do is you can use that Wayback Machine actually to also discover some other con artists in that space by just copy pasting links from IEO websites or so, going back in time and just search for information available prior to that current status right now. So that's really interesting, and we really hope you enjoy that Scambuster tool we are giving on your hands right now. If you are enjoying it, make sure you smash up the like button and also leave your thoughts in the comment section. Do you think that he is Satoshi Nakamoto, or do you think that we actually gave you a proof that he is not Satoshi Nakamoto finally? So that being said, guys, it was a very quick episode, not the most of important episodes out there from us, but it was entertaining and we wanted to cheer you up a little bit and also finally have something to show off when that day comes, because as the time passes and The closer we come to that due date right here, more and more people will pull out that Tulip Trust again to spread some FUD. And what you are able to do then is you can take that link of that video and just share it with those guys. So that being said, guys, thank you so much for coming back to our channel. The next episode will drop very, very soon. So thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting, also coming to our Telegram group, link given down in the description down below as well. So that being said, guys, thank you so much for watching. See you at the next episode of MM Crypto. And as always, guys, bye-bye.